morning guys. I hope you guys will see it in a home, isn't it? Okay, for our last lesson, we see the potential energy of a bar magnet is placed in a uniform magnet. If we see, then we see the tangent element, isn't it? So for potential energy which is placed in a uniform magnet, what do you get? Mu is equal to minus of Pm into B cos theta A theta. Then we see the tangent element. What's the principle of using tangent element? The tangent element works on the principle of tangent law, right? So what is tangent law, guys? Tangent law is when a magnetic needle or magnet will be freely suspended, means it will come to the rest in the direction of suspended of two fields, isn't it? And B is equal to B raised to theta. Then we learn that the construction theory, principle construction theory of a tangent element, will learn. The next field are the magnetic properties, isn't it? Magnetizing field, magnetic permeability, relative permeability, intensity of magnetization, magnetic susceptibility. These are the magnetic moment. These are the points we learned, isn't it? Clear? Clear. Then today's session we are going to see the classification of magnetic materials, okay? Today's session we are going to see the classification of magnetic materials, okay? So the magnetic materials, what is that? The magnetic materials are generally classified as three types based on the behavior of material in the magnetizing field. So the magnetic materials will be generally, the magnetizing material will be generally classified as three types. How it will be classified means based on the behavior of material which is placed in the magnetizing field. So the magnetizing field, the magnetic material will be classified as three types. They are diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. What is that? The magnetic materials are classified as three types. They are diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. So what are the classification of magnetic materials we have? We have three forms. One is paramagnetic, diamagnetic and ferromagnetic, isn't it? Clear? So how the materials are classified? The materials are classified based on the behavior of materials placed in the magnetic field. So first one is diamagnetic. So we know that the orbital motion of electron, what is that? The orbital motion of electron around the nucleus producing a, what is that? Producing a magnetic field which is perpendicular to the plane of paper. Okay, what is that? We know that the orbital motion of an electron revolving around the nucleus producing a magnetic field which will be perpendicular to the plane of paper. So the electron attains the orbital moment, isn't it? So the orbital motion of an electron is producing a magnetic moment. So each electron having an orbital magnetic momentum of electron, since the electrons are moving in random manner, the magnetic momentum of electron will be zero. The magnetic momentum of electron will be, or magnetic momentum of atom will be zero. So what's the first point? Every electron, the orbital motion of electron around the nucleus producing a magnetic field which is perpendicular to the plane of paper. So they have a net magnet, they have a magnetic dipole moment. They have a magnetic moment. Since the electrons are in random manner, so the net orbital motion of electron is not, the net orbital motion of electron, or the magnetic momentum of electron will be zero. The net magnetic momentum of electron will be, or the net magnetic momentum will be zero. So when this atom is placed in a uniform magnetic field, when these atoms are placed in a uniform magnetic field, the electron, sum of electron will be speed up, sum of electron will be moving very slow according to the Lenz law. So the electrons, what is that? The electrons are moving speed when it is moving anti-parallel to the field. What is that? When it will be moving anti-parallel to the magnetic field. So they having a net magnetic momentum. First I say that as the electrons are moving in a random direction, the net magnetic momentum of electron will be zero. When this electron or when the atom is placed in a uniform magnetic field, what happened there? Some of electrons are moving in a speed up, some of electrons are moving in a slower. So how the electrons are moving in speed up means, when this electron moving anti-parallel to the field, or when the magnetic momentum of electron moving in the direction of anti-parallel to the field, the electrons are moving very speed. So the electron attained, or the electron having a net magnetic momentum. When the field will disappear, the net magnetic momentum of electron will be zero. The net magnetic momentum of electron will be zero. Okay? So what's the first point? You taking an atom, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus producing a magnetic field perpendicular to the plane of paper. So they are in a magnetic momentum as such as the electrons are moving in a random direction. So the magnetic momentum will be zero. The magnetic momentum will be zero. So we take an atom. When we take an atom, the magnetic momentum will be zero. Why it is zero? Because the electrons are moving in a random direction. So the magnetic momentum will be zero. The same atom, when we place in a uniform magnetic field, means the what happens here? Some of electrons will be moving in a high speed direction, some of it is moving in a slower. So they are balanced. So when it is will be balanced, means there will be magnetic momentum is there. As such as magnetic momentum is there, means the electrons are moving anti-parallel to the field. Okay. So when there is a magnetic momentum is there, isn't it? So from that, when the atom is placed in a non-uniform electric field, when the atom is placed in a non-uniform magnetic field, the interaction between what is your the interaction between the magnetic field and the magnetic momentum of electron align the material move from stronger part to what is one the stronger part of the field to weaker part of the field. The stronger part of the field to weaker part of the field. This action is called as a diamagnetic action. This action is called as a diamagnetic action, and the material is called as a diamagnetic material. This action is called as a diamagnetic action, and material is called as a diamagnetic materials. The examples of a diamagnetic materials are bismuth, copper, and water. So examples of diamagnetic materials are bismuth, copper, and water. Okay. So what is diamagnetic materials? First, how the material is done. Then when we place in a uniform magnetic field, then when we place in non-uniform magnetic field, then examples. So how? We consider an atom in which the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, so they are producing a magnetic field perpendicular to the pair of electrons due to the orbital motion of the electron. So they have a net magnetic, they have, because as such, when they are moving, means they have a magnetic moment. Here, the electrons are moving in random direction, so the net magnetic momentum will be zero. So when the net magnetic momentum will be zero, means what happens, there will be no interaction. Then, the same atom will be placed in a uniform magnetic field. Some of the electrons will be moving very smoother, some of them will be moving very slower. So how it will be moving smoother means they are moving anti-parallel to the field, according to the Lenz law. Okay. Such as in the last opposite the direction of motions. Okay. So I hope you guys know the Lenz law, isn't it? So here, when there is a presence of magnetic field, there is a magnetic moment will be there. When the magnetic field will be remove means, or when the magnetic field will be switch off means, what happens here? The net magnetic momentum will be zero. In the same case, this material will be placed in our sun. The same material, if the material will be placed in a non-uniform magnetic field means, due to the interaction between the electrons or due to the interaction between the magnetic momentum and magnetic field, this diamagnetic material or the material will be moved from the stronger part of a magnetic field to weaker part of a magnetic field. The action is called as a diamagnetic action, and the materials are called as a diamagnetic materials. Examples: bismuth, copper, and water. Bismuth, copper, and water. Clear? Clear. Now, second material is a paramagnetic material. The next one is a paramagnetic material. Okay. In case in some case of material, each atom or material, the net magnetic dipole moment, the net magnetic dipole moment is due to vector sum of the orbital motion of electron and spin of electron. But the net magnetic momentum will be zero. Why it is zero means because the atom is in the atom or the molecule is moving in a random directions. So in some cases, some of the material having a magnetic dipole moment is sum of the material having a the net magnetic momentum is equal to the vector sum of the orbital motion plus spin motion of our vector sum of the orbital and the spin orbital magnetic moment and the spin magnetic moment. So the net magnetic momentum will be zero because the electron atom or molecules are moving in a random direction. In case this material, such materials are placed in a uniform magnetic field. The dipoles tend to align in the direction of a aligned in the direction of a magnetic field. So when they are aligned in the direction of dipole moment means they having a net magnetic dipole moment. They having a net magnetic dipole moment. Okay. Now this such materials are such type of materials are placed in a non-uniform magnetic field. Such type of materials are placed in a non-uniform magnetic field means the materials are tend to align in the path, tend to move from weaker part to the stronger part of a magnetic field. Tend to move the weaker part to the stronger part of a magnetic field in the direction of a, or tend to align the weaker part to stronger part of a, in the direction of a magnetic field. Okay, such type of materials are called as a, what is that? Such type of materials are called as a paramagnetic materials. Okay, examples are aluminium, chromium, and platinum. So what's the point? In some cases, atoms or molecule having a the net magnetic momentum is due to vector sum of the orbital magnetic moment and spin magnetic moment. As the atoms or molecules are moving in a random manner, the magnetic momentum will be zero. First one. Second point, the same atom is placed in a uniform magnetic field. The dipoles are tend to align in the direction of magnetic moments are aligned in the direction of all the atoms are aligned in the direction of magnetic field. So they having a magnetic dipole moment. Are they having a magnetic moment? They having a magnetic moment. Okay. When the magnetic field will be removed, the atoms are moving in a different directions. Okay. Such as the atoms will be placed in a uniform magnetic, sorry, a non-uniform magnetic field means that atoms are tend to move from a weaker part to stronger part of the magnetic field. They tend to move from a weaker part to stronger part of the magnetic field. Such type of materials are called as a paramagnetic materials. Examples: aluminium, chromium, and platinum. Examples: aluminium, chromium, and platinum. Okay. In which, when the temperature of the material will be increases, when the temperature of the material will be increases due to the thermal vibrations, their magnetic dipole moment will be decreases. Okay. Due to thermal vibration, it will be observed the magnetic dipole moment. Okay. Therefore, the magnetic susceptibility will be decreases with temperature. Such case is called as Curie's law. So, what's Curie's law? Curie's law. So, what is Curie's law states that when the temperature will be increases means, what is that? When the temperature will be increases means due to the thermal vibration, it will be observed the magnetic momentum of electron or magnetic momentum of material. So the magnetic susceptibility will be decreases with temperature. What is that? The magnetic susceptibility will be decreases with the temperature. That's called as a Curie's law. So XM, magnetic susceptibility will be inversely proportional to the temperature. So XM is equal to C by T. Here C represents a Curie's constant and temperature will be expressed in, and the unit of temperature will be Kelvin. Unit of temperature will be Kelvin. So what is state Curie's law? When the temperature increases, what is that? When the temperature increases due to the thermal vibration, the thermal vibration will collide or will make explode the magnetic momentum of electron or magnetic momentum of atom, which case the relative susceptibility will be decreases with the temperature. That will be called as one Curie's law. Okay, that's called as one Curie's law. So the relation is called as one. XM will be inversely proportional to, what is that? XM will be inversely proportional. The relative susceptibility will be inversely proportional to temperature, which is equal to C. It will be expressed in Kelvin. That's called as a Curie's temperature. That's called as a Curie's law. Okay, the relation is called as a Curie's law. Okay, clear? Clear. The third one is a ferromagnet. Ferromagnetic materials are similar to the paramagnetic material. Okay. Ferromagnetic material also similar to the paramagnetic material, but they have the ferromagnetic material contain a small region of space. What is that? They contain the ferromagnetic made up of a small regions, that's called as a ferromagnetic domains. Okay, the ferromagnetic material having a small region of space. Okay, what is that? They having a small region of space, that's called as a ferromagnetic domain. Okay, that's called as a ferromagnetic domain, in which in the domain the atom having a magnetic moment is sum of a orbital magnetic moment and a spin magnetic moment. Okay, when the atoms are moving in a random direction, what is that each domain they are be moving in a different direction. This one, each domain they are moving in a different direction in this level. In which the net magnetic momentum will be what is that? In which the net magnetic momentum will be zero. The net magnetic momentum will be zero. So what's the tag method here? Ferromagnetic method. The ferromagnetic method is also similar to the paramagnetic material. What is that? The ferromagnetic material also similar to the paramagnetic material. In case the ferromagnetic material contains a small region that's called as a ferromagnetic domain. That's ferromagnetic small region that having a ferromagnetic domain. In which domain the atoms are there, the elements are the magnetic moment will be some vector sum of the orbital magnetic moment and spin magnetic moment as they are moving in a random direction. What is that? As they are moving in a random direction, what happened there? As they are moving in a random direction, net magnetic momentum will be zero. The net magnetic momentum will be zero. Okay, clear? Now, when this ferromagnetic materials are placed in a uniform magnetic field, two things will be happen. One is that the domain having magnetic moment parallel to the field growing size. What is that? The domain here, for example, if the magnetic field is like this means, this domain will be parallel to the magnetic field. This will be growing size. So when the ferromagnetic domain will be placed in a uniform magnetic field, the domain which is parallel to the magnetic field growing size. Second one, the other domains are tend to align. What is that? The other domains are tend to align in the direction of a magnetic field. So when the ferromagnetic materials are placed in a uniform magnetic field, the domain which is parallel to the magnetic field are growing size. Second one, the other domains are tend to align in the direction of uniform magnetic field. Okay, the other domains are tend to align in the direction of uniform magnetic field. Clear? Clear. In the same case, if the ferromagnetic materials are placed in a non-uniform magnetic field, the ferromagnetic materials are tend to move from the weaker part to what is a weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. The ferromagnetic materials are tend to move from a weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. And the examples of the ferromagnetic materials are iron, nickel. The examples of iron and nickel and cobalt. Clear? Clear. So, in this, at certain temperature, when the temperature increases, means what is that? Curie's is there. Curie's temperature is there. Okay, Curie's vista. Okay. In Curie's vista, when the temperature increases, the ferromagnetic property of material, or ferromagnetism will be decreases. When the temperature of the ferromagnetic material will be increases, the ferromagnetism will be decreases. At one particular temperature, what happened here? The ferromagnetic material will be converted into paramagnetic material. What is that? The ferromagnetic material will be converted into paramagnetic material. The temperature is called as the critical temperature or the Curie temperature. What is that? When the temperature will be increases, the ferromagnetic property. Okay, what is that? The ferromagnetism will be decreases. At one temperature, the ferromagnetic material will be converted into paramagnetic material. The temperature is called as a Curie temperature. And the relative successivity also decreases in temperature. So X is equal to C by T minus Tc. Here C represents the Curie's constant, the temperature will be expressed in a Kelvin law. This relation is called as a Curie's ratio. Okay. So these are the classification of a diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. Okay. Here, whatever point you have to remember means, first point, when it is placed in a uniform magnetic field, they are aligned, so they have a magnetic moment. When the uniform magnetic field will be removed means, They are moving in the random direction, so the magnetic momentum will be 0. That is the first point. For a problem for every diamagnetic, paramagnetic, ferromagnetic. At the same time, what's the point is zippo means when it is placed in a non-uniform magnetic field means. Sorry, non-uniform magnetic field means. What is done? When these materials are placed in a non-uniform magnetic field means the materials which is moving from stronger part to weaker part of the field. The material style is a diamagnetic material and the action style is a diamagnetic action. Example, bismuth, copper, water. At the same time, when the materials are placed in a non-uniform magnetic field, it moves from weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. It moves from a weaker to stronger part of a magnetic field means they call it as a paramagnetic. They call it as a paramagnetic. Example, aluminum, chromium, and platinum. At the same time, the same cases, the same paramagnetic material having a certain region of domain means, a certain region means this called as a ferrodomain, that type of material is called as a ferromagnetic material. That also, when it is placed in a uniform magnetic field means, the domain which is parallel to the magnetic field, which will grow in size, and the other domains are tend to align in the direction of a magnetic field. Okay, and also when it is placed in a non-uniform magnetic field means, they move from weaker to stronger part. They move from weaker to stronger part. The examples are iron, nickel, and cobalt. Examples are iron, nickel, and cobalt. For paramagnetic material, there will be two risks. One is Lewis gas means when a temperature increases means due to the thermal vibration, the magnetic momentum also decreases. Okay, so the relative susceptibility will be decreases with temperature. So the star is a so which makes the relation Xc will be inversely proportional to the temperature. So Xc is equal to C by D. That star is a Curie's law. That star is a Curie's law. And next one is a Curie's law. Here, when the temperature will be increases, the metal lost their ferromagnetic property. At one case, the ferromagnetic material will be converted into paramagnetic material because the domains will be defined, changed. So the ferromagnetic material will be converted into paramagnetic material and the temperature is called as a Curie temperature and the relation Xc is equal to C by D minus Tc is called, the relation is called as a Curie's phase law. Okay? Here C represents the Curie's constant. C represents the Curie's constant. Clear? Clear. Compare para-ferro diamagnetism. Okay, compare the diamagnetic paramagnetism and ferromagnetism. Okay, so for that, there will be four points. That point you have to write. Okay, that point you have to write. Okay, clear. First one, the magnetic for diamagnetic material, the magnetic susceptibility will be negative. The magnetic susceptibility will be the magnetic susceptibility is negative. The paramagnetic it will be positive and small. It will be positive and the magnetic susceptibility is positive and small. And ferromagnetic, the paramagnetic susceptibility is positive and large. The magnetic susceptibility is positive and large. So what's the first point is the magnetic susceptibility is negative. The magnetic susceptibility is positive and small. The magnetic susceptibility is positive and large. Second point, the relative permeability. What is the relative permeability? Okay, the relative permeability is lesser than unity. The relative permeability is lesser than unity. Here, the relative permeability will be greater than unity. Here, the relative permeability will be very large. The relative permeability will be very large. So, what's the second point? Here, the relative permeability will be less than unity. Here the relative permeability will be greater than unity. Here the relative permeability will be very large. And third point, when it is placed in the presence of a non-uniform magnetic field, it moves from stronger part to weaker part of a magnetic field. The stronger part to weaker part of a magnetic field. It moves from stronger part to weaker part of a magnetic field. When the paramagnetic materials are placed in a non-uniform magnetic field, it moves from weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. Weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. At At the same time, when the paramagnetic vectors are placed in non-uniform magnetic field, they also move from weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. Weaker part to stronger part of a magnetic field. Okay. And the last one, the susceptibility. Okay. For susceptibility, it will be independent of temperature. The susceptibility will be independent of, almost independent of temperature. For paramagnetic material, the susceptibility will be inversely proportional to the temperature. The susceptibility will be inversely proportional to the temperature. And for ferromagnetic also, the susceptibility will be inversely proportional to temperature. The susceptibility will be inversely proportional to temperature. And the last one is some examples of that magnet. For here, examples are bismuth, copper, water. For paramagnetic, examples are aluminium, chromium, platinum. For ferromagnetic, examples are iron, nickel, copper. So if a question is done, compare diamagnetic, paramagnetic, ferromagnetic uniform, you have to write this first 5 points, okay? You have to write this 5 points. So whatever point is the, for diamagnetic, the sensitivity is negative, for paramagnetic, sensitivity is small and large, positive and small, for ferromagnetic, the sensitivity will be positive and large. Here the relative probability will be less than unity, relative probability greater than unity, relative probability very large. Here in the presence of a non-uniform magnetic field, what is that? In the presence of a non-uniform magnetic field, it moves from the stronger to weaker part of a magnetic field. Here it moves from weaker to stronger part of a magnetic field. Here it moves from weaker to stronger part of a magnetic field. And it will be independent of the temperature, it will be inversely proportional to the temperature. This also inversely proportional to the temperature. And like examples of bismuth, copper and water, aluminum, chromium, platinum, and that one last one is the iron, nickel and copper. So these are the classification of the magnetic materials, okay? So the magnetic materials are classified as these types based on the behavior of magnetic material when it is placed in the magnetic field. So we have magnetic field. So we have three types of magnetic materials. What are they? Diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. And one of the important MoMA questions, they will ask the examples, okay? Examples of a diamagnetic, they can ask for a one-mark questions. Examples of a diamagnetic, paramagnetic, ferromagnetic, they may ask for a one-mark questions. Okay? Clear? The next one is the series. The series is when you back to the school, we'll take up. Yeah? Okay? Clear? Magnetic effect of current, okay? In the year 1820, Sir Dan Christian was told, okay? Magnetic effect of current, okay? In the year 1820, Sir Dan Christian was told, okay? Who is that? Sir Dan Christian was told, he found that when a current flows through the wire, when a current carrying wire producing a deflection in the magnetic medium. So he said when the current will be deflected, in the presence of magnetic field only, the magnet will be deflected. So whenever the current flows through the wire, what happens there? The magnetic field will be deflected. So he said that whenever the current flows through the wire, whenever the electric field flows passing through the material, producing a magnetic field. So you unify the two concepts. What is one? Electricity and magnetism into single concept called the electromagnetism. Electromagnetism. Okay. Today's last lab, there will be our experiment will be there. First one is that the magnetic field around the sky current carrying wire. And second one is the magnetic field around the circular. First one, magnetic field along the straight line. Magnetic field along the straight line means when a current anywhere carries a current means producing a magnetic field in the form of concentric circles. Okay, producing a magnetic field in the form of concentric circles. So when a current carrying wire producing a magnetic field, when a compass passes through here means it will be reflected in the form of concentric circles. And the direction of current producing, what is that? The direction of current producing, the direction of the magnetic field will be either a clockwise or anti-clockwise. What is that? The direction of magnetic field may be either clockwise or anti-clockwise, depend upon the direction of flow of current. What is that? Depends upon the direction of flow of current. And the strength of a current, what is that? The strength of a magnetic field also depends upon what is that? The strength of a magnetic field also depends upon the distance of distance from the magnetic field. Okay, distance from the magnetic field. Okay, the relative strength of a magnetic field, what is that? The relative strength of a magnetic field or the density of a magnetic field also depends upon the distance from the magnetic field. At the same time, for a circular wire, when a current carrying wire, what is that? When a current carrying wire producing a, or when a current passes through, what is that? When a current will be passes through a circular current means, we are also producing concentric circles. Magnetic field also producing the form of concentric circles at the center of the loop. The magnetic field will be almost in the form of straight line. Here also, the strength of the magnetic field will be depends upon the number of turns of a circular loop and also the current passes flowing through the coil. Okay? Clear? The next one is the two important things. First one is the right hand thumb rule and second one is the Maxwell's right hand screw rule. Okay? What is the two point? First one is the Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. So if you are holding a hand like this, means the thumb pointing the direction of current and the fingers pointing the direction of flow of magnetic field. Okay, so the thumb points the magnetic field, so thumb points the current flow direction and the remaining finger points the magnetic field. Okay, that's called as the right hand thumb rule. Okay, that's called as the right hand thumb rule. What side hand rule? If you are holding a connector like this, what is that? For example, assuming the chalk pieces are connected means, if I holding the conductor like this means, what is that? If I holding a conductor like this means, the thumb points the direction of current and the curl fingers, the curl of a fingers is points the direction of a magnetic field. Okay, the next one is that Maxwell's right hand screw rule. You are assuming a screw. If you are tightening a screw means, screw is moving in this direction, same. If you are tightening a screw means the screw will be moving this direction. Yeah? So the direction of screw, the direction of motion of the screw which represents in the current means the motion of the screw which represents what is that? The rotating motion of the screw which represents the magnetic field. So the direction of the screw which represents what is that? The direction of the screw which represents the magnetic current means the rotating motion of the screw which represents the direction of magnetic field. Okay, so for this session we have learned the classification of materials and just received the introduction of magnetic effect of current, in which you have to learn the two topics. One is the Maxwell's right hand thumb rule, and Maxwell's right hand clock screw rule. Okay, clear. And one more important thing, the comparison of ferrofluoride materials will be one of the important three mark questions. And also the comparison in which they can ask for a new question, the examples, what is the examples of para, diaphora, they can ask for a important one more question. So you should be learned very clear. So I hope you should be understand the session. So you should be learned very clear. Okay, thank you.